हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम प्रांगुर गुप्ता एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड कीवर्ड्स एंड डेटा टाइप्स इन जावा। सो व्हाट आर कीवर्ड्स इन जावा? कीवर्ड्स आर द रिजर्व वर्ड्स इन एनी लैंग्वेज दैट हैव सम प्री डिफाइंड मीनिंग एंड वी कॉन्ट चेंज द मीनिंग्स ऑफ दीज कीवर्ड्स फॉर अवर ओन पर्पस। देर आर टोटल 53 कीवर्ड्स बट आई हैव मैंशन हेयर ओनली 48। द फाइव कीवर्ड्स दैट आई हैव नॉट मैंशन आर ट्रू, फॉल्स, नल, गो टू एंड कॉन्स्टेंट। True, false and nulls can be used as a constant also, so they don't treat as a true keywords. But go to and constants are not used in these days in Java. They are used in C and C++. Why? Because instead of constant we used final keyword, and go to is a keyword which is used to control, to transfer the control from one statement to any other statement in a program, which is not a good programming practice. That is why we don't use go to and constant. Now let's see what are the new keywords in Java. Abstract is a new keyword. As you have seen in C and C++, we use pure virtual function. Pure virtual function, in whatever class we have used pure virtual function, that class becomes an abstract class. But here in Java there is nothing like pure virtual functions, so to declare any class as an abstract class we have to mention this keyword. Now default is a new keyword used in Java. Default is an access modifier. We will discuss it later when we will cover the topics of access modifiers. And also there is a implements. Implements is also a new keyword used to inherit any interface. Import is a new keyword which is used to import any external source file. Instance of keyword is used to compare two references. Now there is a keyword named package. Package, now every class in Java is contained in some package, so to define the package name we have to mention the name of the package using package keyword. There is a keyword named strict fp. Strict fp is basically used within variable so that whenever we try to apply any operation on this variable, then this operation result will same as in different platforms. Because let me tell you with the help of example, if there is a variable and we use strict fp with it, then we apply any floating point operation in this variable, then whatever result will come that will be same for any other platform also. For Windows, for Linux, for Ubuntu, for Unix, for Linux, for all platforms the result will be same after operation. Now synchronize is basically used for synchronization between threads. If there is a same resource, or you can say shared resource for two threads, then they both can't access that resource simultaneously. First one thread will access that source, then after the usage second thread will come and access that source. Okay, so these are all new keywords that are used in Java. Some of the keywords I have not covered because some keywords needs to be covered with their topics, so you will get clear about those keywords when I will cover those topics. Now let's move to the data types in Java. There are two data types in Java, primitive and non-primitive. Primitive data types are those data types which gets memory in stack, and non-primitive data types are those data types which gets memory in heap. So I will tell you in my next slide how they get memory, but before that let me tell you what are the types of primitive and non-primitive. In primitive there are numeric and non-numeric. In under numeric there is integer type data type and floating point type. Under non-numeric there is a character and boolean type. We will discuss them in my later slides. Now I am not covering non-primitive data types in this lesson because these all are vast topics, so I will cover them individually in my later lessons. In this lesson we will focus on primitive data types. Let's discuss how primitive and non-primitive data types gets memory in RAM, or you can say memory. Now I have declared here int I. By before getting start, let me tell you that all the primitive data types by default have zero value, like numeric, for numerics only, and all the non-primitive data types have by default null value. Now, if we declared here int I and we do not initialize it, then by default it contains 0. And where it gets memory? In stack. So basically, I is a reference which gets memory in stack and with value 0. Why? Because we did not initialize it. Now, I have initialized here j with 4. Now, it gets memory in stack with the value 4. Now, here is a class. It is an non-primitive data type. Because it is a class, object is a class. Object is a base class for all classes in Java. Whatever inbuilt class we will use in Java, that is inherited from object class. Object is a base class of all classes in Java. Now, object obj, object obj means it will just create a reference in stack. It will not give memory to the object. It means a reference is created in stack. And by default, the value of non-primitives are null, so here null will be stored. If we initialize it using new keyword, then it will get memory in heap. And how it will get memory? Object obj means, first, this statement means that it will create a new reference in stack, and when this line will execute, then a new object will be created in heap whose address is stored along with this reference. So if this reference is pointing to this object which is present in heap. Now I hope you get the clear idea how primitive and non-primitive data types get stored in memory. Now let's move to next slide, in which I have mentioned the sizes of all the data types. Here, character which have a size of 2 bytes. Now, 2 bytes means it can cover all the characters like Unicode, universal codes. So, it can cover all the codes like in Punjabi language, Hindi language, or you can say any other language that used in this universe can be covered in this character data type. And byte. Because in character is of 1 byte in C and C++, so that just only cover the ASCII values, which is ranging from 0 to 255. Now byte is a new data type in Java which stores integral type data. Integral means integer. So but the only difference is it has a size of 1 byte. In short, is same as C and C++. Integer is of 4 bytes according to standard C++. Float is of 4 bytes, long is of 8 bytes, double is of 8 bytes, and boolean is new which was introduced in standard C++, and in Java also we used boolean keyword to store false bool value like false and true. These are all the ranges of these data types. Now let's see with the help of example how these data types works. Now here byte b is equal to 10, it will get memory in stack. Now if I try to give a value beyond the range of byte, then it will give compilation error. As we have seen that bytes range is -128 to 127, and if I try to assign 130 value to byte, then it will give us compilation error. It is not only for byte, for all data types. If we try to assign a value greater than the range of data type, then it will throw a compilation error. Now short, we have stored 56 in short, which is in the range of short. Int i is equal to 14, which is in the range of int, and long is equals to 45, which is in the range of long. Now floating point. Now here float. Now I have given value to float 12.5f. It is showing that a float value of 12.5 is storing in the flow f. Now it will get memory in stack. But if I try to assign a value float f is equals to 2.5, then it will throw a compilation error. Why? Because by default, if we do not mention f, then it will take it as a double. So we have to mention f with the value, otherwise it will take it as a double. So that is why it will not throw error in C and C++. It will accept it, but as Java is a strongly typed language, so we have to mention f with that. And double d is equals to 16.8. Now character c is equals to e. By default the value of float is 0.0 if we do not initialize the variable, and by default in character the value is this null character. Now character c is equals to e. It means that in c a value of a sky value of e will store, and when we try to print character c, it will print e. Now boolean, by default boolean is false, but if we try to assign a value to boolean, as in this case I have given value to b, boolean b is equals to true, then it will print true on the screen. So guys, this is all about primitive data types. I hope you get the clear idea how these primitive data types works. Now in my next lessons I will be covering how to convert from one data type to other data type. For now being, this is all about primitive data types and keywords. I hope you like my video. If you like it, then don't forget to follow and share this video. This is my Una Academy profiling.